Pramod Kumar. Today we will study English, class 12, Bihar Board, Rainbow Part 2. And our chapter is A Pinch of Snuff, written by Manohar Malgaonkar. Pinch, something that we can hold between our thumb and the nearest finger. Snuff, tobacco powder that people use for taking in their nose. Would like to know some meaning of difficult words before we get into the chapter. Fawning, displaying exaggerated flattery. Fuss, to be worried or excited about a small things. Garnish, to decorate food with a small amount of another food. Haughty, proud and thinking that you are better than others. Bustling, to move in an excited, noisy way. Spar, to argue. Brass tacks, the essentials, the basic facts. Ingratiating, to establish in the favor of someone. Flicking, to hit something lightly or quickly, like this. Burnt his boat, destroy all possible ways of going back. Right? This article is full of wit. W-I-T. This article is full of wit. Wit means ability to use words or ideas in a clever and amusing way. The writer has done in this chapter. This chapter is full of wit and adventure, and this is also full of profound comedy. All through the chapter, comedy runs. This writer, Manohar Malgaonkar, was a big hunter, a civil servant, a mine owner, and also a farmer. So first we will understand who are the main characters in this chapter. Okay? So main characters in this chapter are the narrator, who is narrating the story to us, and he is an undersecretary with the government. His rank is of an undersecretary in the government. Then his mother. Third character is Nanu Kaka. Nanu Kaka is the narrator's maternal uncle, mama. So one day, the mother tells him that Nanu Kaka is coming. So the narrator is disturbed. He says, can we not tell him that we are out or we are going out? Mother says, no, he would have already started. So he asked his mother for what he is coming. So his mother said he is coming to meet some minister. Then it created more trouble for the narrator. So he went to the railway station to receive his maternal uncle. So he was wearing his typical attire, and he got down the train. So he was coming with a ticket checker, and he was saying that I was carrying a third class ticket, but I travelled in a second class, and it was very well accommodated by the kind ticket checker. So he came straight, then he asked his nephew, when have you arranged my meeting with the minister? So the undersecretary, the narrator, was taken aback, because he knew that he doesn't have enough power, and he was undersecretary, and that also under probation. He was yet to be confirmed. He was under probation period. So he came home, The mother put his maternal uncle's bed in the room of the under secretary. So it created more problems for him. He didn't want to be disturbed by anybody. So when they were coming from the railway station, somebody crossed, passed from the opposite side in a very fast moving car, and that person waved to the under secretary. So his maternal uncle asked, "Who is this man? He's driving like a mad person." So he said, "He's Rati Lal, who works in the government, and he was supposed to go for foreign assignment, but it was cancelled. And he is the son of Sohan Lal, Rati Lal, political party boss in Delhi." So Nanu Kaka caught this thing, that Rati Lal is the son of Sohan Lal Rati Lal, and Sohan Lal Rati Lal is the political party chief at Delhi. So he said, "We'll go and meet Sohan Lal Rati Lal." So under secretary said, "His nephew, that I don't know him." He said, "Don't worry, we will go there." So he changed the dress of under secretary, told him to wear traditional dress, and they went to the Sohan Rati Lal's place. So the secretary of the Sohan Rati Lal was not willing to make them meet Sohan Lal Rati Lal. But these people, maternal uncle Nanu Kaka, acted in such a way that Sohan Lal Rati Lal himself came out of his room and met them. So this Nanu Kaka acted in such a way as if he knows the ambassador, so that he could influence the foreign posting of Rati Lal, Sohan Lal Rati Lal's son. So they had a very good chat, and Sohan Lal Rati Lal was also interested in Nanu Kaka because he wanted his son to go abroad for a foreign posting. They met, had a very good talk. Nanu Kaka did everything to influence Sohan Lal Rati Lal, to make an influence on him. Then they came back. During their interaction with the Sohan Lal Rati Lal, Nanu Kaka came to know that Sohan Lal Rati Lal wanted to marry his son to the daughter of minister. But the minister wanted his daughter to be married to a person somewhat of a prince, someone like a prince. So Sohan Lal Rati Lal was very cut up with the minister, because the minister had refused to marry his daughter to Sohan Lal Rati Lal's son. So they came back, and Nanu Kaka told his nephew that you arrange a luxurious car. We will go to the minister's house in that car. So the undersecretary was very reluctant, but Nanu Kaka impressed upon him. So they went to a car dealer, and Nanu Kaka did everything to show to the car dealer that he was a financially very strong person. And the car dealer was influenced, so he gave them that car, the luxurious car that they wanted for going to the minister's house. So Nanu Kaka made his nephew under secretary the driver of the car, and he sat in the back seat. So they went there. So there Nanu Kaka showed that he was in too much of a hurry, didn't want to disturb the minister, and asked for the visitor's book. And in the book, he wrote his name, and he wrote as if he was astrologer to a princely family, princely estate, astrologer of a princely estate. And the name of that princely estate he wrote, Ninnor. and below that he gave the address of the under secretary's house. So the minister had not come out, so he signed, came back. While getting out of the minister's house, he told the driver in a loud voice, "Let us go to the castle of king's palace." And this was overheard by the minister from the top floor above them. So on the way, the undersecretary told his maternal uncle, "It will create problems. You have given my address. Tomorrow they will come to know that you are not an astrologer to a princely estate and you have given my address." So Nalukaka reassured him, "Don't worry, nothing will happen." They came home. Next day, the minister was at the undersecretary's home to meet the so-called astrologer, this Nanukaka. So Nanukaka and the minister had some discussions between themselves. Undersecretary was away. And after some time, the minister left. And undersecretary never knew what they had talked. And after a day or two, Nanukaka returned back to his home. So, the narrator was thinking that tomorrow they may find out the truth and they may find out that this is my address, so I may get into trouble. But then he thought again that Nanukaka is so smart that he will take care of all this. So, he was slightly reassured. So, in this chapter, we will talk briefly. This chapter is full of wit and adventure. It is also full of profound comedy. This writer, Manohar Malgaonkar, was a big hunter, a civil servant, a mine owner, and a farmer also. The main characters are mother of the narrator, who is very much attached to her side of the family. Mother is very much attached. And she believes whatever her brother says, Nanukaka says. She doesn't doubt his words. Another character is narrator, the undersecretary, who is narrating all this to us. He is an undersecretary with the government. He is a simple-minded, grounded in reality, and doesn't believe in everything that Nanukaka says. He doesn't believe in any pomp, pageantry, or any show-off. He didn't believe in influencing anybody for his own benefit. Right? And then another character is Nanukaka. He is very street smart, intelligent in reading people's minds. He is capable of knowing, he is capable of getting his work done. And he can influence anybody through his sharp mind. He knows the ways of the world. And he knows how to influence people. So, this is all about this chapter. I hope you found it easy to understand. A pinch of snuff means even big things like meeting a minister, which is a very difficult task from the viewpoint of undersecretary also. And Nanukaka makes these things so easy as a pinch of snuff, right? Undersecretary finds it very difficult to arrange a meeting for Nanukaka with the minister. And Nanukaka is so smart, he makes that meeting with the minister so easy. And such a difficult task of arranging a meeting with the minister is like a pinch of snuff for Nanukaka. He is so smart, so intelligent, so worldly wise. So this is all the story about. I hope you found it easy to understand. In case of any difficulty, please approach me on my email ID, which will be there on the thumbnail to the video. Thank you very much.